Welcome to the toolboxshop.com video tech log. We're going to be trying demonstrating some products as we go. Obviously, this is the first of the tech logs. Today, we're going to be covering switch relays and switch solenoids. Hopefully, giving you a demonstration of a switch solenoid in operation, where you can see the insides of what you usually can't because it's in a box. First up today, we have make and break relays. Make and break relays is basically making a circuit and breaking the circuit. Right? So all we have on here is usually, 9 times out of 10, we'll have 4 terminals. You can have a dual make and break, but for this example we're going to show you, the 4 terminal single line break. So we have inside the box, which some may have seen inside, some may not have, we have a coil. The coil is energized with a positive and negative feed. The positive and negative feed, when energized, makes the switch or breaks the switch. So this is main line coming out here. Many probably have seen the wiring diagrams for a relay and not realized that the outer lines are thicker than the inner lines. That's because you need less current to switch your coil, to turn your coil on. Right? Once the coil is energized, then you're breaking the line which you are using in your circuit. That line can be different amperages, different size cable. So your main line is the one that you'll see a thicker line going onto your circuit diagram. On the diagram, you'll see the switch. So basically, we're switching on and we're switching off a circuit. That is your make and break. Next up, we have changeover relays. Changeover relays, we are talking about, instead of usually 4, like the make and break relay, we're talking 5 terminals. Again, standard, use it 5 terminals. The reason being is, instead of just one circuit, we're going to swap from one circuit to another. Right? So basically, same principle with the coil. We energize the coil with a positive and negative. We have this line coming in, and then we're going to switch from one function to another on the positive line. So that's the reason we've got the 5 terminals, and that is a changeover relay. There's other types of relays out there. We haven't talked about the suppression, the diodes, or the resistors. The information online will explain that, and you know, if you have a resistor there for suppression, then that's, you know, what you require. Try and always, this is a 9 times out of 10 scenario again, try always put back what you take out. Good enough is not always good enough. There's a reason why these things are in. There's a reason why there's a tracking diode inside a relay switch. If you go and put an ordinary one in, possibility it'll work. But which would you rather do? Change a relay or change your engine management system? Because sometimes it's there for a reason to stop the feedback going into the circuit. Latching relays. There's not a circuit diagram up here, but I will put a diagram up, hopefully, now. Yeah. Latching relays. Basically, what you're doing with the latching relay is, instead of switching over the circuit, and then when the coil is energized, it switches back, what you're doing is allowing the circuit to be made. So if you switch the circuit and then you power off, it will stay made in the power off position. So that's basically a latching relay. And again, if you notice in front of me, we're going up in size. We're going up in size when we have a duty of amperage that we need to carry the current. There is a video coming up which will show you how to get to the solenoid section, to the relay section, and explain a little bit about how it's laid out and how you find it in there. Again, if you're a customer, a regular customer of the toolbox shop, you'll know exactly your way around, but sometimes you need a helping hand to navigate the auto electrical section, which, to be honest, is laid out as possibly an engineer would like to look for it. It's certainly how we like to look for our information. So it basically, just underneath the banner on the left-hand side, you have auto electrical, and you follow the auto electrical through with images, that takes you to the relevant section. So if you're looking for a fuse, it's auto electrical, fuses, and then specific fuse gear inside there. These that have got in front of me here, in this section, are single acting, single coil. So what we do is, again, energise the coil and making and breaking a circuit. Obviously, on the top here, probably better to show you from that angle. So we basically, positive, negative, energise the coil, the contacts will make and break, and this is where your line is coming in and going out. So you're breaking your line, you're switching it on, and it's allowing it to stay powered on. I've got an SW60. I've got an SW80. We'll be getting close-ups of these as well. We've got an SW180, and we've got the SW200. Obviously, like I said, the higher the amperage, the higher the bigger the coil, and the bigger the circuit. So, for example, I have down here in front of me some small light duty wire, obviously crocodile clips on the end, but this is the type of wire that you're wiring a relay up with. If we was to go down the avenue of wiring in one of these, and bear in mind this is SW200, biggest of the lot, at 70% duty, we'll be talking about 300 amps capability. So we'll be talking about cable bigger than this. This would probably be suitable for a SW60 or a SW80. So SW80, this particular one I've got in my hand, is a 16mm square. 16mm, the one that we supply, flexible, very flexible. That runs about 135 amps max load. Max duty, sorry. So max duty, what is max duty? Well, max duty is if it's always on 135 amps, it can cope with no problem. Taking it above 135 amps. Okay, so we say 135 amps is a problem, because if you are going up to 135 amps, you've got no room for deviation. So 100% duty, what the cable is telling you is, it will deal with 130 amps. So a switch solenoid like an SW80 that we're running 70% duty on about 120, you'll be talking about 16-25mm onwards. In front of us we have the SW180 series. We could be using this for a line contactor or a hydraulic contactor. If we was going to be using it for motor reversing, we would possibly move away from this and move on to what we call a strapped pair. A strapped pair is two that are joined together, and we use those for motor reversing, forward and reverse on an electric motor, DC current. The later versions of these are the DC. 182 DC 66, very small form, motor reversing solenoids. A DC 182 that I have in there, and there's one in between which is a DC 88, which I haven't got out, but trust me, it's there, which is a DC 88. So this is the later version of that, but these are still being put on as a straightforward, easy to understand option on motor reversing. Talking and losing my voice at the same time. So we have a coil, we have a switch. And somebody once said it makes a nice clunk sound. Yeah, it is. It's peace of mind clunk sound, to be honest. So there we go. Make. Break. Chatter. We'll try that again. So we said basically, we have single acting solenoid, energizing the coil, and making it. So on the switch solenoids, we do two types of versions. We do the intermittent version, we do the continuous version. The intermittent versions are designed to be pulled in for the shortest period of time, but they do have a stronger coil, so you will get a quicker switching action from an intermittent, but they're not designed for prolonged periods of time. So anything sort of venturing past, 15 seconds, 20 seconds, you then want to start looking at using a continuous version, or possibly giving us a ring and walking through what the circuit is doing, what the operation is doing, because 9 times out of 10 you could be working on a piece of kit that you want to put these in application, and we've already been through it, so we know which is the most common one to use. So basically, we have a single switch solenoid, and we make and we break. Again, I'm using 1 millimeter cable on this because all I'm doing is energizing the coil. But if I was taking these feeds off of the top of the coil, which is basically the circuit, the cable that I'm breaking and creating the circuit with, on a 200 size like that, I would be using possibly 16, 25, 35 millimeter. Depending on the amperage, depends on the cable. 16 millimeters squared, the one that we keep and supply, that's good for 135 amps at max duty. Max duty means always on, always running, 135 amps, top side. Excuse me, voice again. Again, just to explain the website structure, it's very basically set out. So, not to insult, but not to make it difficult to find the products that you need quickly, easily, and you know, find the actual piece of kit that you've got there in front of you on the bench. If you go to the toolboxshop.com for the first time, a bit of a clue is we're specialists in auto electrical, so the auto electrical section is where you want to be starting. Just underneath the banner on the left hand side, you'll see the auto electrical button. You click on that, it'll open it up, and for example, the best way to actually trial it and see it is to go with a preconception of a product or a part that you've got there on the bench, or you've had there on the bench in the past, and try to look for it that way. So if it's a fuse, if it's fuse gear, you go auto electrical, fuses obviously. In the fuse section, it'll break it down into the components for the fuses. Very similarly, if it's a relay that we're working on today, you go to the auto electrical section, go to the relays and ignition, go into the voltage of the relays, because 12, 24 is common, 12 on standard automotive, and then 24 on specific heavier duty HGV type vehicles. So you go into the relevant section, which is possibly 12 volt relays and flashers. Then you've got your 12 volt make and break, which we explained on the make and break diagram. And then you've got the changeover, 12 volt changeovers. Everything is laid out in a logical progression so that when you start looking for a product that you want in, if you start with the auto electrical, 9 times out of 10, you'll find it so easy to cycle through the menus and find exactly what you're looking for. If at any point you do have a problem, the through the working day, the guys on the telephone and they will assist you. Simple as that. Thank you for watching our first video tech log, and we hope you enjoyed the products that we're demonstrating, and we hope to see you back soon. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel, and you'll get a notification when the next video is uploaded. Hopefully I'll be a bit more articulate. Hopefully I won't have a sore throat. I apologise in advance that I'll still have a Yorkshire accent. Take care.